The control of flowering. Have you ever noticed when you go outside, all of one species of plant will flower at the same time? Daffodils flower early in spring. Something causes plants all over a region to flower at the same time. And it comes down to one chemical called phytochrome. Phytochrome is a weird chemical in that it's found in two forms. You've got the phytochrome red form and the phytochrome far red form. Now, these are interchangeable. One breaks down to the other in the dark. We end up in the dark with a lot of phytochrome red. When sun shines on this, when certain wavelengths of light shine on this, we get the conversion to the phytochrome far red. So every day and every night, we get a cycle of phytochrome. Plants can flower only in response to this guy, phytochrome far red. The far red shape is the one that dictates when a plant will flower. That is really important. So phytochrome far red only affects flowering. We can actually draw a slightly more detailed diagram than before. We start off with our phytochrome red. We have our phytochrome far red. During the day, we get a very fast conversion as soon as we have daylight or white or red light. We get a very fast breakdown of phytochrome red to phytochrome far red, the far red being the one that will cause flowering. At night, we get a much slower breakdown back to phytochrome red. This occurs in the dark, or if we shine far red light. So you can imagine every morning we're going to have lots of phytochrome red. Daylight all day long, we've got a lot of this at night. So we're in a daily cycle. However, there's more than just a daily cycle. Some seasons have longer days or nights, so we can end up with cycles within the season. Before we look at that, we need to look at when do plants flower. There are some flowers that will flower anytime, opportunists, but many species have a set season. All flowering is due to night length only. The only thing is night length, which affects our phytochrome far red. The two groups of flowers we have are for some reason called short day plants, which really means long night, since night is the only thing that can affect flowering. And we have long day plants, which really means short night. So these flower when the night is greater than a certain trigger length. The long day plant flower, remember long day really means short night, when the night is less than a certain length, which means we can say, hold on a minute, when the night are greater than the length, that's going to be generally in winter, or the season when nights are getting longer before winter, autumn. So things that flower in autumn or winter are flowering in response to nights getting longer, short day. On the other hand, things that flower when the night is shorter than a certain time are going to flower when nights get shorter, spring, or into summer. So as soon as you see when a flower appears, you can work out if it's a short day or a long day plant. This means different plants have different sensitivities to phytochrome. We go back up here in daylight, very quick, slow breakdown at night. In the summer, nights are very short. There's not going to be enough time for all of this to break down. We're going to end up with less of this, more of this. Plants that flower then will respond to having this present. In the winter, short day, very long nights, we end up with less of this. But this system goes on forever, and on top of that, your plant groups have a different sensitivity. So if we go back a step, we have phytochrome far red. It inhibits short day flowering, whereas our phytochrome far red promotes flowering in long day plants. You could take all of this and put it onto one diagram to explain it, where you've got the basic system. Your phytochrome far red is going to have two effects. Now, phytochrome far red will inhibit flowering in short day, which means long night, plants. Inhibit them from flowering, and our far red will promote flowering in long day plants. Now, obviously, you're going to get a daily cycle. Every morning, you're going to have more phytochrome red. Every afternoon, evening, more phytochrome far red. We're talking about when your level gets high enough for a period of time, it will promote flowering. Or when it's lower than a certain level for a period of time, then your short day plants could flower because they're no longer inhibited. Now, scientists learned a while ago they can mess with this. Scientists found in the middle of winter, when you have long nights, 30 seconds of bright light in the middle of the night is enough for the very quick conversion back to phytochrome far red. So flower growers could grow summer flowers in the middle of winter and sell them for a premium price. This was all because they understood the role of phytochrome in the control of flowering.